Yo, what is up guys? Been a long time, but today's video I kind of want to dedicate it to these recent events that have been going on with Destiny, and I think it's time I kind of speak my mind about the game and its current state. As many of you know, there's been like a lot of drama going on with Destiny, and you know what? It may kind of sound bandwagonish, but I'm going to go ahead and jump on the side that everyone's been siding with. You know, I'm not really happy with how Bungie has been handling things. I'm not trying to say that they're killing the game, because I know they love the game and they want what's best for it, but you know, what's been going on recently has really kind of, I wouldn't say pissed me off, but has me a little frustrated. You know, Destiny means a lot to me. You know, it's more than just a game to me at this point. You know, I have a YouTube channel behind it. I've met a lot of really good friends. I just enjoy the game. It's a really good game. You know, community's great. You know, seeing how passionate people are about this game on Reddit and other websites, and just like some of the videos people make, you know, there's a lot of passion behind this game. Basically, everything I'm about to say is only because I really love this game and I want what's best for it. I'm not making this video, or I'm not, you know, saying this stuff because I hate the game, I want it to fail. You know, there's people out there that actually want this game to fail, and it's kind of disappointing. You know, I want games to succeed, but I want them to reach their maximum potential, and this game by far has not reached its maximum potential. I think Bungie knows that, but they're really handling things very fucking poor. What I mean by this is that they're lying to us in the weekly update, which I don't know why they would take that route of lying to us, because we're gonna figure out the truth. You know, for example, year one, we knew that something happened with the campaign, that it got ripped apart. Whatever happened with that, we figured it out pretty quick. So the fact that they would lie to us about skill-based matchmaking and like the auto rifle buff thing, that it just blows my mind that they think were that stupid or that gullible to just fall into whatever they say. You know, at first I was willing to let the auto rifle thing slide. Basically what I'm talking about is that they said that there was going to be like a 2%, 5%, 7% buff to auto rifles across the board for certain types of them, and then when the update finally hit, we couldn't tell that there was a buff for them, and then they came out and said, oh, we're sorry, it was 0.02%. Which, you know, a buff like that is so minimal that you would never, ever, ever notice that. 0.02. That's very fucking small. So, I don't know what the fuck's going on there. And, you know, also them lying about skill-based matchmaking. Of course we're going to notice that. Every fucking match we play is the same people. You know, skill-based matchmaking almost never works. When it's working, everyone's angry. And guess what? Everyone's fucking angry. So you need to take out skill-based matchmaking. That's honestly a no-brainer. Anyone who's for skill-based matchmaking just simply doesn't understand PvP that well. You never want to add like a skill-based matchmaking type system for a game across the board. Maybe if there was like rank play and social, I would understand, you know, skill-based matchmaking for like rank play. But that's a different video. I may make a video about that. But Triple Rec probably worded it the best. Just go check out Triple Rec's channel. I think it's his newest video. He made a pretty good video detailing, you know, his feelings about Destiny at the moment and his thoughts about skill-based matchmaking and PvP. So the next major issue I have with Destiny at the moment is they're not telling us, you know, Bungie isn't telling us anything about future DLC. I don't know why. Like, it's leading me to honestly assume the worst, and I think that's the case, that there is no DLC, and that right now they're probably forming some team at Bungie right now to quickly scramble a DLC for us. And the thought of that is honestly, it's not scaring me, but it's like making me a little angry, because I don't want another DLC that was like Dark Below that you could tell was quickly crafted just to release to us. But you know, looking at the bigger picture, that would probably help us at the moment, because the game is really dry. I would say majority of the people who play Destiny a lot are definitely hardcore players, and right now they're probably bored, don't have much to do. Iron Banner doesn't excite them because PvP right now is a mess. But one thing you guys really have to keep in mind is that, you know, making content, you know, the developers are seriously strained. I don't know how they do it. I have a feeling that there's people at Bungie who honestly probably work 15-hour days. And I think one thing, you know, they really need to do is fix their tools. There's been rumors going around that their tools are very inadequate. I think part of that problem has to do with 360 and PS3, but I don't want to be the guy that says it, because I don't want to get scapegoated for saying, oh, it's PS3 owner's fault. No, it's not your fault. There's just a lot of factors that play into this, and I'm just sick of all these problems that this game is having. I just want them to reach the potential that this game has, and I hope this next, you know, that's one thing people keep saying, I hope, I hope, I want, I want. and we're just simply not getting that. You know, we're kind of leaning on a false hope that this game will just magically like pick itself up, and I just don't really see that happening for a while. Case in point, you know, developers can't just shit out content in like 1 or 2 months. It's going to take some serious time, and I think that's why you're hearing those rumors about Destiny 2 being delayed, because I think what Bungie did, they quickly put some teams together to make a DLC for us that'll probably come out maybe June, maybe August, and then we'll have our major Destiny release probably just after 2017, so probably a year from now we'll be playing the next major Destiny game. But this is all just really disappointing. You know, for one second, I can't believe that Activision and a team at Bungie thought that this free small event system would work and hold us over to the next major game. I have a tough time believing that. There's no way that they thought taking out DLC would keep us enticed or entertained for a full year and a half, or however long it's going to be till the next game. Moving forward, I would like to see Bungie do two things. Number one, take out skill-based matchmaking. It's just not fun. I know majority of the PvP player base could probably attest to this. Having to sweat every match and, you know, do your utmost best just to play PvP is not fun at all. You know, if you play in full six mans using Thorn Last Word, that's perfectly fine. If that's how you have fun, go for it. But I just don't want to keep connecting to you guys. I want to use No Lambion in the sidearm. I want to try out the Necrochasm. And if I keep backing out and get matched up with the same people every day, every game, it's just not fun. I don't have fun with skill-based matchmaking. It was like that on Advanced Warfare, and it feels like that with Destiny at the moment. So please just take it out, Bungie. Number two, give us, you know, show us your hand. Give us a teaser of what DLC we're going to get for this year. If there is any DLC, just tell us the truth. Don't make up any white lies or false advertise or anything. You did mention in the weekly update big ticket content. So what is big ticket? Is that a raid? Is that a couple strikes? Is that new gear? What is big ticket? So we'll have to wait and find out. Hopefully they don't kind of mislead us. And I really hope that's not the direction they're going. But if they do have any sort of DLC, give us some designer art. Like you did with Darkblade, that was really cool. Make a teaser for the next raid or something. You know, the King's Fall teaser was awesome. It made me so excited to play the raid when it first came out. So I hope Bungie pulls a trick out of their sleeve. I really hope they can like bounce back from this, but this one's pretty rough. You know, they've been through some shit, but this one's probably the deepest shit they've been in. So let me know what you guys think in the comments. If you enjoyed, I know I haven't really been uploading much, and I'll explain that later. So let me know what you guys think in the comments. I'm actually very curious to know, and I'll be reading. And I'll catch you guys again next time. Take care.